7月1日是中英联合声明保障香港高度自治50年不变的第23个年头，中共强制推行的香港国安法也开始实施。虽然七一大游行事先收到警方反对通知书，但当天仍有众多港人自发走上街头抗议恶法，反对中共剥夺香港人的基本权利。 媒体普遍报道，有300多人被抓，9人被控违反国安法。中共在香港新设立的驻港国安公署是一个独立于香港政府及司法系统的中共执法机构，其经办的案件由大陆司法系统审理，实质上就是送中处理。同时，其第38条的规定更是将中共管辖权扩张到全世界。
Article 38 of the new law also purports to apply to offenses committed outside of Hong Kong by non-residents of Hong Kong, and this likely includes Americans. This is outrageous and an affront to all nations.
蓬佩奥表示，将继续落实制裁，包括结束美国给予香港的特殊贸易待遇。
We'll continue to do all the things that we can, and importantly, we will continue to build out a global coalition that understands the challenge that the Chinese Communist Party threat places on freedom-loving peoples all across the world. This isn't a U.S.-China challenge. This is a challenge that is between freedom and authoritarianism.
对于美国何时会祭出金融制裁，蓬佩奥重申了川普总统的立场。
Just repeat what the president said. He wants to ensure, with a handful of exceptions, that Hong Kong is treated just like mainland China.
美国国会则是大力推动川普政府制裁中共。
We refuse to speak out on human rights in China because of commercial interest. We lose all moral authority to speak out for human rights any place in the world.
众议员史密斯呼吁两党合作，全球合作应对中共威胁。
The world needs to unite against this pervasive human rights abuser, Xi Jinping, and this draconian law that they just put into effect.
This is a battle between democracy and dictatorship, between liberty and tyranny, and between freedom and oppression. And it is a battle that the world must win.
美国国会参众两院30日已提出香港避风港法案，给予部分香港人优先难民庇护。新唐人记者李兰综合报道。